Well, lots of different reaction to the military operations. In Britain, there appears to be inconsistency about the aims the coalition is pursuing in Libya. Prime Minister Cameron says that regime change is not on the table, but the UK defense and foreign secretaries have said that there is a possibility that troops could target Colonel Gaddafi. RT's Laura Emmett has the latest from London.
The government, both in front of it seems and also behind the scenes, is arguing that Gaddafi himself could be construed as a threat to the civilian population, and therefore it would be legal and within the terms of the UN Security Council resolution to endeavour to target him. On the other side, we've got the army and the chief of the defence staff, who, when asked if he thought it was permitted under the terms of the resolution to target Gaddafi personally, he unequivocally said absolutely not, and said that he didn't want to discuss it any further. We are seeing in this, therefore, international division as well. Senior people in Washington also say that direct strikes against Gaddafi would not be permitted under the terms of the Security Council resolution. Now, why is this so important? Well, of course, it belies confusion within the ranks as far as this no-fly zone and this military intervention is concerned. It shows a lack of planning. Why weren't these questions discussed before they went in? Were they, in fact, and the UN Security Council ruled them out, but now the resolution is open to a bit of playing with words, a bit of interpretation. After the ferocity of those first airstrikes that we saw, the Arab League said, this is not really what we signed up for. It also raises the spectre of those dreaded words, regime change, which brings up shades of Iraq. Not very many people in this country, the general feeling would be that this country would not tolerate another Iraq-like situation. So the government is being urged by factions inside it to stick religiously to the terms of this UN Security Council resolution to avoid this mission creep and to avoid this sort of open-ended commitment to having military intervention in the region. But it seems that with this reinterpretation of what the resolution actually means, this kind of playing with the words, the government isn't actually doing that and doesn't look like it will.